Rob Skiba giving glory to the Baphomet, aka Satan, on his book cover. Exposed. The name of Rob Skiba's book is called Seed. Subtitle, The Keys to the Future Lies Buried in the Past. Rob Skiba says, the keys to the future lies buried in the past. So right off the bat, Rob Skiba wants to direct your attention to the subliminal images found in the bottom portion of his book cover. But before we get into the subliminal images on Rob Skiba's book cover, I want you to hear another YouTuber by the name of Carl Roberts that have also peeped out Rob Skiba demonic subliminals on this very book cover. Here is the video.
So I wanted to talk about the symbolism in this image. Now this is Rob Skiba, and it's absolutely evil. And the reason is, in my opinion, is because Rob Skiba is an evil individual. I do not believe that Rob Skiba is who he says he is. I believe he's most likely a Jesuit, probably a failed actor. He's been placed into the truth community like so many have been very early on to lead people astray. And all you have to do these days to lead people astray is claim to be a Christian and talk about flat earth, and that will get you not only through the door, but it will get you in somebody's home, and they will give you access to their life. They will listen to your videos nonstop because you mention the name of Jesus and you talk about flat earth. But I want to call your attention to the symbolism here. Now, there may be something here I'm missing, so I would just ask anybody to please leave comments in the in the comment section and call my head and help me see anything that I'm missing. Well, let's look at the tree. All right, this tree here is a symbol of as above, so below. This is a witchcraft symbol. As above, so below. As well, you have the bluish light above and then the reddish light below. You know, here's that duality reference as well with the blue and red. You know, you see this on police sirens, you see it on can of Pepsi. All right, you see it everywhere. Blue and red. Democrats and Republicans, on and on and on it goes. All right, so we see here this tree as above, so below symbolism in it. Then with the red and blue duality. And then if we look inside the two E's, and this is really evil, we see S-E-E-D, seed, right? It's supposed to be Rob Skiba's seed logo. But notice that second E, it's turned around the wrong way. And this forms a symbol if you look in between it. And what you have is the double-barred cross, the cross of Lorraine. And this is a Jesuit symbol. It's a Jesuit symbol. Just look it up, people. So we have the as above, so below symbolism. With the tree, we have the red and blue duality reference again, like as above, so below. And then in the word seed, with the second E turned the wrong way, you have the double barred cross of Lorraine, which is a Jesuit symbol. Now, surely we're not naive enough out there to think someone who's supposed to be such a truther like Rob Skiba would use this type of symbolism unknowingly or ignorantly. Surely he knows this, and I believe that he does. And I believe that he has been put into the truth community very early on to lead people astray. He is a limited hangout. All right, these people that he's associated with, like Now You See TV, these people are as well. All these people flock together. But this symbolism right here is quite something. As above, so below. the blue and the red, and then the E turned the wrong way in the word seed, which makes the cross of Lorraine, which is a Jesuit symbol. You guys can look it up and see for yourself. This is witchcraft, which is what we're looking at. This is witchcraft. And Skiba, you're exposed. You are an exposed individual.
Carl Roberts brought out some great revelatory information and asked if anyone saw more on the book cover to please comment. And so it's time to comment. Rob Skiba claimed to be a Christian, but his book cover says something entirely different. Here is a clearer image of Rob Skiba's book cover. On this book cover, you will find DNA, sperm, Satan, a needle, a penis, the Baphomet twice, the all-seeing eye of Lucifer, and a human, all found on Rob Skiba's book cover. Number one, the eye. Notice the subliminal image of an eye, showing the iris partly blue and partly red, with the sun forming the pupil. This represents the all-seeing eye of Lucifer. Number two, the Baphomet. Rob Skiba shows a subliminal image of the Baphomet on his book cover. I will drop in two red dots over the already existing eyes of the Baphomet and a red star. Okay, you guys, so you guys can see this subliminal image of the Baphomet right here at the top of the tree. This is his left eye, and this is his right eye. If you guys just look closely, you can see this. This is the white of his left eye, and here's the pupil. And this is the white of the right eye, and here's the pupil. So what I'm going to do is drop in two red dots right over the already existing eyes that are already present here. So let's do that. Okay, there you go. You see that, you guys? So if I was to take that away, you are able to see the eyes. You see that? There's the left eye, and there's the right eye. They're right here. This is put in a subliminal form because the powers that be, the Illuminati, Rob Skiba, wants this to be planted into your subconscious mind. As I told you before, once something is planted into your subconscious mind, it doesn't matter if it is true or false, right or wrong, good or bad. Once a subliminal image is planted in your subconscious mind, your subconscious mind take it in as truth. And what you were once maybe not had anything to do with, you now find yourself tolerating it. So this is a subliminal image here, you guys, designed to go into your subconscious mind. So once again, I'm going to drop those two red dots right over the already eyes that are existing on this book cover. There you go. And then also I want to bring your attention to the star. You guys see the subliminal star here? It comes to a point. There it goes here. It comes down. And this part is covered up in the black, but you can see the point here. You see that? This is a star, you guys. That is what that is. That's why this little leaf part even comes all the way out. It is a star. One, two, three. You can see three points here, okay? And the other two are down here at the bottom. But this is a subliminal image of a star. Okay, and the reason why they place that like that is because of this guy here, the Baphomet. The Baphomet is always depicted with this star here in his forehead. He is always seen in this fashion, and this is the reason why you see this subliminal image of a star here, because it is in reference to the Baphomet. Number three, the Baphomet again. I want to direct your attention to the Baphomet again, located in the bottom of the tree. I will place subliminal image on its side to bring the Baphomet out of hiding. People, do you see the Baphomet again? Now at the top of the tree. He is hiding in plain sight. Okay, so what we're going to do is look at this Baphomet. You see him right here, you guys? You can see his head clear as day. Okay, you can see his teeth. You can see his lips right here. But you can clearly see his teeth. You can see his nostril area. You can see his left eye. And you can see this little dot of his right eye. Here is a subliminal image of the star here in his forehead. This is what this is sticking up here. But you can clearly see the face of this individual, of this demon. It looks like a dragon, but it is a subliminal image of the Baphomet. And you can see his body in a curvature fashion as it goes around. And this is his left hind leg, and this lighter part here is his hoof. Just like you see the hoof here, you see that? That's what this is, you guys. It is his left hind leg hoof. Just like you see this hoof, that's the reason why this is lighter here, because it is a hoof. So you can see this Baphomet, this goat demon here, and he is here hiding in plain sight. Number four, penis. Also, people, do you see what the Baphomet is holding in his hands? A penis. The Baphomet is holding in his hand his penis. So once again, you guys see the face of the Baphomet, and he's looking quite disgusting. You can see his teeth, his lips, his nostril area. You can see his clearly his left eye as his body wraps around, okay, in a curvature type fashion. And you can see his left hind leg with his hoof. This right here is his right arm, okay? And this is his left arm. With his right and left arm, he is holding his penis, people. The Baphomet is always showing his penis, as you can see here in this image here. This is the Baphomet as he sits on his throne. He is showing his penis outright. And so this is nothing new for the Baphomet to do. So once again, you see the subliminal image of the Baphomet as his body is in a curvature type position with his left hind leg and the hoof, and his right arm, as it is holding his penis, okay? He is holding his penis. Number five, sperm. So why is the Baphomet holding his penis in his hand? Because the Baphomet is ejaculating his sperm, his DNA, into a needle. Okay, you guys, once again, you see the Baphomet just as clear as day up here in a curvature type position with his hind left leg and the hoof clearly being seen. This is his right arm, his left arm, and this is the Baphomet's penis, a subliminal image of the Baphomet's penis as he is ejaculating his sperm slash DNA into this image here. Okay? To make it plain and simple, the Baphomet is marking. He is claiming a territory, just as a dog would do. Number 6, the needle. Rob Skiba shows a subliminal image of a needle. The needle is the catalyst to mix the Baphomet's DNA with the human's DNA, thus making a new seed, a new being. I will flip subliminal image on its side to bring the needle out of hiding. People, here is the subliminal image of the needle on this book cover. So, you guys, this here, this stick here, you see how it's shaped like a stick? And it has a point on one end and a point on the other end, and you can actually see two eyes here, you guys, and you can see the mouth here. Okay, you can see the right eye and the left eye. The left eye is kind of in like a shady area, but you can still see it. And here is the right eye. It's right there, you guys. Okay, and if I were to put two dots in there so that you guys can see the face a little better, I'll do that right now. Okay, you see that? You can see the nose area. You can see the mouth here. Okay, so if I was to take that away again, you would see the eyes. You can see the right eye right there. And then the left eye is more shaded in, but it is right there. And you can see the right eyes clear as day. You can see the nose. And you can see the mouth area. So I'm going to drop that eye back in. There you go. So you see this little stick figure that has a point on both ends. And so this stick figure represents a needle. Jesus said, as it were in the days of Noah, so shall it be with the coming of the Son of Man. In the days of Noah, Satan was mixing his DNA with the DNA of humans and animals. Number 7, humans. Rob Skiba shows a subliminal image of a human. The Baphomet, aka Satan's DNA, being mixed with the human's DNA, thus making a new seed. I would turn image on its side to bring out subliminal image of human. There is a human with the right arm lifted high, located in the red portion of the image. I will drop into the face two white dots over the already existing eyes. Okay, you guys, you can clearly see this image right here. You see here? And it is like sitting here, and it has its right leg crossed over the left leg here. You see that? And that's his foot down here. And this is his face right here. And his right arm is extended upward. You see that? The right arm is extended upward. Here is the face. This is the body. This is the lower torso. This is his right leg as it crosses over the left leg that's going straight down. So this is an image of a person. Now, whether or not it's a male or female, I really can't tell. It's kind of standing in a little bit feminine position, but I don't know if it's a male or a female. So I'm going to drop in two white dots so that you guys can get a good place as to where the face is, if some of you guys couldn't see it thus far. Okay, there it goes. So that's the face right there, you guys. You see that? And you can see his arm going up. This is his body, the upper torso. And then you see the lower torso as this right leg crosses over. This is his foot. And you can see the left leg as it is going straight down. Okay? That's the human on there. Number 8, DNA. The DNA symbol is placed on the right side of the human's body. The DNA symbol is located in other places as well. Okay, you guys, this right here is a symbol of a person's DNA. And do you see this DNA symbol placed right here, mid-waisted on this person, whether it's a male or female, like I said, I'm not sure. But you can see that this DNA symbol is right here. And then you can also see the DNA symbol here. And you can see it again right here, you guys. Okay? So it's there for a reason. The DNA symbol is there for a reason. Do know that the Bible says the mark will be given in the right hand. The original Greek meaning for the words right hand also means right side, as you see in the image. So in this image on Rob Skiba's book cover, you can see that the DNA symbol is placed right here on the right side of this person here. Okay? So keep in mind that the right hand also means the right side. There's a reason why the powers that be, these Luciferians, have placed this DNA symbol right here in the right side, you guys. And then they place it again down here because they want you to know that the DNA is something very important to them. Rob Skiba says, the keys to the future lies buried in the past. So what Rob Skiba is really saying, the success of Satan's future of mixing his seed with mankind lies hidden in the past blueprint of Satan mixing his seed with the seed of mankind, as in the days of Noah. Jesus said, as it were in the days of Noah, so shall it be with the coming of the Son of Man. In the days of Noah, Satan was mixing his DNA with the DNA of humans and animals. DNA, sperm, Satan, needle, and a penis, the Baphomet twice, the all-seeing eye of Lucifer, and a human, all found on Rob Skiba's book cover. The mark of the beast will be placed in your right hand. The original Greek meaning for the words right hand also means right side, as shown on the book cover. So you guys see this DNA here? It is shown in this person's right side. As you see, their right arm is extended over their head. And you can see this little shot. As you can see, the DNA extension, and it goes into a DNA. So it's letting you know that this needle here is being plunged into the DNA. Okay, you guys, you see that? This is what this picture is showing you, that this needle here is being plunged into the right side, into the DNA of a person, as the symbol shows you. Remember, the beast that speaks like a dragon in the book of Revelations, the 13th chapter. This beast deceiveth them that dwell on the earth. Many say you will have free will in taking the mark of the beast, but this is not entirely true. For you will be deceived first, and then you will take the mark of the beast as a result of being deceived. People, you are going to be tricked into taking the mark of the beast. It will be your free will, your decision, but you will make it in the bed of pure deception. So why would the beast deceive you? Because if you knew the truth, you would run quickly the other way. The beast calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. The original Greek meaning for the word calls it means to make. So how does the beast make you take the mark? It is through deception, people. Remember, the Bible says the beast deceiveth them that dwell on the earth. This is why Jesus has said constantly, take heed, let no man deceive you. Jesus knew that deception in the end times would be at an all-time high. The beast calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. The word did not say on the right hand or on the forehead, but it says in the right hand or in the forehead. Meaning, this mark is not like a tattoo, something you can see, but it is something that you cannot see, for it is placed inside of the body. When you look for this scripture, Revelations 13 and 16, in the King James Bible, it read as such, in the right hand and in the forehead. But when you look for this same verse in the New International Bible and the New King James Bible, and practically every other Bible, they all say on the right hand or on the forehead. This is inaccurate according to the King James Version of the Bible. So while people wait and look for the mark of the beast to be placed on the right hand or on the forehead, Satan is busy placing the mark of the beast in the right hand or in the forehead. Wake up, people. According to the King James Bible, the mark of the beast is something that goes in the right hand or in the forehead. Not on, but in. And remember, The original Greek meaning for the words right hand also means right side. So a right arm will qualify as the right hand. You don't believe me? Look it up, people. Revelations 13 and 16. King James Version Bible, please. People, there are so many more subliminal images located on this book cover. But for the sake of time, I will stop now. People, there are many so-called men of God that are getting snatched out of this life, never to return again. People, the Most High is most definitely cleaning his house of many wolves walking around in sheep's clothing. For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Rob Skiba, the author of Seed, died October 13th, 2021 from COVID-19. People, the judgment of God is real. Many more prominent leaders, false teachers, false prophets will fall, never being heard from again. The message is for all those that have an ear to hear. Trust in the Most High with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. The jab is not a new start, but you're soon burning hell in the dark. All right, take heed, let no man deceive you. Yahshua loves you. Be blessed.